In this example, we're going to factor this algebraic expression. So the first thing I always look for is if there's a greatest common factor, and it looks like the first term is all x's and the last term has no x's, so there will not be a greatest common factor. So the next thing I need to decide is if I'm going to use grouping here, should I group it into three groups of two or two groups of three? So let's look for pairs first. If I take an x squared out, then I have an x plus 4. But if I take a 2x out here, I won't end up with an x plus 4. So let's go ahead and break it into two groups of 3 instead. So the greatest common factor here looks like just a single x. So I'll have x squared plus 4x plus 4. And here it looks like I'll have a positive 2, so I'll put plus 2. Okay, so that looks like it'll be x squared plus 4x plus 4. And my leftovers here are the same, so I know that I can factor those out. And my other factor will be the x and the positive 2. But it looks like what we have here is a quadratic trinomial. The leading coefficient is 1, so I look to factor this down as well. So what multiplies to make positive 4? That adds to make positive 4. Well, factors of 4 are 1 and 4 and 2 and 2. And this is positive and this is positive, so we know that these will all be positive over here. And it looks like positive 2 and positive 2 works really well. So this will factor down to x plus 2 times x plus 2, and that'll go nicely with the other factor that we already have, that's x plus 2. So all three factors are exactly the same. So I'm going to say it's x plus 2 quantity cubed. And here is the full final factorization for this original algebraic expression.